We go. Welcome, everybody. This is Dr. Jeffrey Hanna here at Clear Chiropractic. Welcome to The Big Idea. Here we are today in a little bit of a different recording studio. We're actually in the x-ray room itself because there's a wonderful blue-black ground here. But I'll just sort of spin the camera around over there where we've got the x-ray unit, where we've got the diagnostic scan, my mic showing you a little bit of the silly behind-the-scenes kind of stuff here. And today what I've got here is brand new research, really, really top of the line stuff. And I know right off the bat, it's like, okay, you know, how interesting is this going to be? Maybe this is something that appeals a little bit more to chiropractors. But I will say that this arguably is a really important concept for people who maybe have already been to see a chiropractor. They thought that this was going to help out, but for some reason it didn't. And this very well might explain one of those reasons why it was. It's all about specificity and making sure that the adjustment, the care that you are receiving is actually targeted for the part of your body that needs it the very most. Let's jump into it. All right, this is from the all-star team down at the New Zealand College of Chiropractic. A randomized controlled trial comparing different sites of high velocity, low amplitude thrust on sensory motor integration parameters. And I want to highlight here, this is published in the Nature Journal, which is one of the most preeminent journals that is out there. Let me give you the broad brush overview of what this is all about. What the researchers did is they wanted to have a look at two groups of people, because we can have all kinds of different levels of the spine. Some that are actually locked up and others that are nothing more than compensations. And there's an idea that's been floating around for well over 100 years. It doesn't really matter exactly which way you are going to be restoring motion through the joints of the spine. All that you have to do is just get motion into some area and that's going to help. Well, we've disagreed with that for a really, really long time. There's an old expression, chiropractic is specific or it is nothing. Question is where's the science to actually back up? Here's the science that's going to back that up. What they did, they said, okay, in this double-blinded, active-controlled, parallel design study, 96 adults with recurrent mild neck pain, ache, or stiffness were randomly allocated to receiving a single thrust directed at either segment considered as relevant or a segment considered as non-relevant in their upper cervical spine. They broke people up into two groups, and they had a series of clinicians, people who had at least 10 years of clinical experience, do a series of motion tests, challenge tests, to say, yes, there is something going on at this particular level of the spine. They were looking at C1, C2, or C3. That was it. They said, okay, there either is a problem that we suspect is here and we think that it's gone this way, or we think that this is relatively in the clear. They wanted to see then, was there actually a difference then when an adjustment was applied to an area that they think is actually locked out of alignment, versus one that maybe it's just a compensation here. SEPs, so somatosensory evoked potentials of median nerve stimulation were recorded before and immediately after a single high velocity, low amplitude application delivered using an adjustment instrument called an activator. What's an activator? An activator is a little chiropractic tool like this. It produces what's known as a high velocity, low amplitude thrust, a little mechanical impulse like that. You can see it makes a little bit of a click noise. The point being is that you don't have to twist, crack, manipulate a joint into place in order to make a correction. It's more a matter of giving it a light and precise tap in the direction of correction. The body's able to make the healing and repair on the other side of that, because it's never the medication, it's never the stretch, it's never even the adjustment that helps a person heal. It's their own body. The question is can you get rid of that source of interference that's preventing it? Or if you would, you have a locked door, so you put a key into the lock, unlock it, and then it just releases and opens. you don't have to twist or crack things into place. They also chose to use the instrument because they knew that they could do it reproducibly. It had nothing to do then with the individual skill of the practitioner. And what they measured is what's known as a somatosensory evoked potential. In other words, an EEG. They wanted to see were there changes with brain activity itself as a result of an adjustment either in an area that is locked out of alignment versus one that we think is actually relatively normal. So they do their statistical kind of thing there. Pairwise comparisons showed a significant immediate decrease in the N30 complex amplitude after the application of a high velocity, low amplitude thrust to a segment considered relevant. In contrast, no significant change was observed in the group that received the high velocity, low amplitude thrust over a segment considered non-relevant. In other words, there were not any changes with brain activity in an area of the spine that was thrusted upon when it was not actually locked out of alignment, when it was just a relative mobilization, as we would do with a stretch, with an exercise, or with just, you know, willy-nilly move them, crack them, different kinds of that. But if it was a precise, vectored approach in an area where there was actually some testing done first to see, is this actually an area that requires an adjustment in the first place? That was there a significant change of brain activity, where the brain then was able to remap and start to make more of the appropriate changes, what's called neuroplasticity, that are going to allow the body to function at a higher level, ultimately to heal. So let me unpack that for just a little bit of a second there again. We can have any number of different problems going on in our body. There's 24 individual movable segments in the spine, each one having multiple joints that can sometimes go forward, can go backward. Some are designed to turn, some are tilting up and down. We need to understand the three-dimensionality of how all of the bits and pieces fit together. Point, though, is that where we experience pain is not always where the problem is. It can be, for example, you've got a problem in the upper part of your neck that causes your head to tip like this. Well, that's not going to be very useful, so your body finds ways of compensating like that. Problem, though, is that's going to put stress and strain on your muscles, your ligaments, and on your nerves. And as you can see, as I'm illustrating with my shoulder just like that, over a period of time, depending on where we carry our stress on our daily activities, it's those areas where we're most likely going to feel where the problem is. If then there are areas of tightness through here and we're focusing all of our treatment on where the pain is, but without considering, well, maybe that's not where it's coming from in the first place, guess what this is going to illustrate? This study is going to say, no, that will not produce the right kind of brain changes that are necessary for the body to actually be able to address that. So where the pain is not always where the problem is. Question then, how do you tell where the problem is? This is where, whether it's in a massage setting, a physical therapy setting, a medical setting, or a chiropractic setting, it is essential that we treat people as individuals. We all have different kinds of things going on with us. Yes, common things happen commonly, rare things happen rarely. So I can say, based on all of my years of experience and practice, the weak link in the spine is oftentimes the upper part of the neck. And because it influences circulation to the brain, because it influences all of the neural traffic up and down to the brain, this is one of the most important and most common areas where you're actually going to find primary problems. As a result, if that area of the spine is not right, the rest of the body can't be right either. Now, still, does that mean that that's the only thing that a person may need? No. This is why we do a series of physical tests, orthopedic tests, neurological tests. But what is also very important is precise diagnostic imaging. That shows us what is the exact location, direction, and degree of misalignment that is going on in the spine so that we know that any adjustment, any procedure that we're going to be doing is going to target that part in the way that it's going to actually respond and produce the brain-based changes that need to happen in order for the body to actually heal. So what I've got here for you, this is an example of what's called a cone beam CT scan. I have borrowed this one from one of my colleagues. Thank you very much, Dr. Hollowell down in Brazil. Hi there. And what we have here, as you can see, this is an upright, complete three-dimensional reconstruction of a person's head-neck alignment, where you can see not just the bones, but you can see the individual joints to see where are things actually in neutral alignment or where you see evidence of a disrelationship. Not broken, not dislocated, but locked out of that normal position. And if what we're seeing here matches what our functional tests are saying, guess what? The evidence is pointing us in the direction that even if there isn't pain at that spot, that's the area of the spine that we need to focus. Now, the cool thing with these particular scans here, these actually use less ionizing radiation than a standard series of x-rays. It's like a chest CT or a full spine CT. That's where we get like the mega doses of radiation. This is extremely low dose. And yet you can see things from every single which way, every single angle that you may need to see in order to determine if, as an example through here, something is sitting where it's supposed to, or if that piece should actually be sitting more toward the back here, showing, okay, the thing is misaligned forward. Now, as I had mentioned a little bit, why is this important? Especially if people have been to chiropractor before and they were finding, no, this should have worked, but for some reason I wasn't really getting any better. I did a bit of a research project myself going back a couple of years, and I looked at 300 consecutive cases, people who had come to the practice, and I wanted to see what was the prevalence of the various misalignments that they had. In a nutshell, what I found was that 90% of the misalignments occurring at the C1 and the C2 vertebra in particular had misaligned forward, which makes sense if you think about the ways that we're most likely going to injure our neck, have whiplash injuries, head snaps forward like this. Then you compound that with the way that we text, we type, we read, we write, the head is sticking forward like this in front of computer screens all day. It's far more likely then that we're going to see these kinds of forward misalignments. What that means then is that a procedure where we're pushing the spine from back to front will not actually solve that problem. That'll be more like poking a bruise. It's not going to resolve it. Instead, then, what we need to do is we need to measure, well, what are the angles of the individual joints? As I said before, this is not twisting cracking. This is putting the right key in the right lock. It will go in. It will release on its own. When you know that, so that you're giving the adjustment in the right way, as the research is now showing, that will produce a change that happens in the brain that facilitates healing, that facilitates function in a way that random mobilization, random manipulation, or focusing on where the pain is without addressing where the problem is coming from in the first place cannot actually achieve. So again, this might just be the chiropractor in me geeking out a little bit here. But again, this particular message, I want this one to go, number one, to people who are in the field. But number two, to people who perhaps have already been doing all of the different things. You know, you're experiencing headache, migraine, dizziness, vertigo, problems in this part of your body, or maybe even other parts of your body that you are not thinking or don't realize could be connected with an issue in your neck. And as a result, you've been doing what should be working, but you're not getting the results that you're actually looking for. between the tests that we do and what this research is now showing, this very well may explain why that has been. And this then gives you an opportunity to do something different, to look at things from a different perspective so that you can achieve the breakthrough that you're looking for and experience the benefits to your health, to your life that you've been looking for such a long period of time. So, thank you guys, as always, for watching the video. Please do hit that like and subscribe button. Share this video with friends, family, clients, colleagues who you think would benefit from having a look to have a bit more of an appreciation of the work that we do in our practice here. And if you want to reach out to us, you can visit us through clearchirospokane.com or give us a ring direct, 509-315-8166. We will be happy to have a chat with you to find out a little bit about your history, to see if there's something that we can offer that's going to be different, and ultimately put together again a solution that is going to be best fitted so that you can get back to doing the things in life that matter the most to you. Thanks for watching again. This is Dr. Jeffrey Hanna at Clear Chiropractic here in Spokane, Washington. Get well, live well, stay well. Till next time, take care. Bye-bye.